Hi, I'm Jason Brown with ESAB Welding and Cutting. I operate a demo van out of the Northeast region of the United States, and one of the most popular products that we have in the demo van today is this machine we have here. It is the ESAB Rogue 200 IP Pro. Now we're going to go through some of the parameter adjustments on the Rogue 200 IP Pro. If you see here on the left, you'll see some symbols. We have the first one here is a little TIG torch with the HF symbol. That is the high freak start option for the TIG. The next option is our lift arc TIG. And then we have a stick electrode holder symbol there, which is for stick mode. On the other side over here, we have a few other symbols. The first one here is for your trigger mode, 2T versus 4T. Your second option here is to turn your pulsing on and off. And then to adjust the frequency of the pulsing, we come down here to the last setting here where we can adjust the frequency. Now, there's another hidden menu inside here as well. If you come over here to this button where you'd select your process, you can hold that down for a few seconds and it gives you your parameter adjustments. Our first option here is pre-flow gas. Then we have ignition start current. We have our slope up. We have our background current. We have our slope down and our finish current there as well. And then our post-flow gas setting. We can hold that down or let it go back into the menu after a few seconds and it'll go back to the main screen where we will adjust our amperage. Now, this knob here is going to be for our maximum current. We also have a potentiometer on the TIG torch, which goes from 0 to 10, and we can adjust the output. If you see here, I will set this to 10 and then pick my max current, and then I can adjust up to that max current from 10 amps up to whatever I have this set for on the potentiometer. We also have the torch button here as well that will allow us to initiate the high frequency start on the TIG torch. It also works if we're using lift TIG. If we're going to do the lift TIG option, we'll use that button as well. Some other features that come into these settings are the gas pre-flow and post-flow. When you're running with a scratch start, you're typically using like a gas valve torch where you just leave the gas on. In a machine, this 200 IP Pro, we have a solenoid built into it that allows it to control the gas flow through the machine. So we can set our pre-flow and post-flow. When we're using lift TIG or high freak start, we have that ability. When we press the button and then we press it to stop, or if we're using the trigger lock, we can do it press and hold, however you have it set up. It'll allow those settings to control the pre-flow and post-flow of the gas. Like I said, with the scratch start, you don't have that control.